data interpretation, our next chapter for quantitative aptitude. Data interpretation is the process of reviewing data through some predefined processes, which will help assign some meaning to the data and arrive at a relevant conclusion. It involves taking the result of data analysis, making inferences on the relation studied, and using them to conclude. The different types of data charts which are used for data interpretation are table charts, pie charts, bar charts, and line charts. First, let's see the illustration of a table chart. Study the following table and answer the questions based on it. Expenditures of a company in lakh rupees per annum over the given years. The years are 1998, 1999, 2000, 2001, 2002, and the index of expenditure are salary, fuel and transport, bonus, interest on loans and taxes, and given below are the amounts. So now let's see the first question. First question asks, what is the average amount of interest per year which the company had to pay during this period? To answer this question clearly, you have to understand the table properly. And as it is asking the average of the interest, then you have to find the mean of the values 23.4, 32.5, 41.6, 36.4 and 49.4 lakh per annum. And the required answer is 36.66 lakhs. Next question. The total expenditure of the company over these items during the year 2000 is. Now to find out this answer, you have to just add all the values which are given in the column which lead to year 2000. So this is the illustration with few examples on table chart. Next we'll know about pie chart. And to understand this properly, let's see this illustration. The following pie chart shows the percentage distribution of the expenditure incurred in publishing a book. Study the pie chart and answer the questions based on it. This pie chart shows various expenditures in percentage incurred in publishing a book, like royalty, binding, paper cost, transportation cost, printing cost, and promotion costs. If for a certain quantity of books, the publisher has to pay Rs 30,600 as printing cost, then what will be amount of royalty to be paid for these books? Now from the pie chart, we can clearly know that paper cost is 25% and royalties 15%. Now given that the amount of paper cost is 30,600, so it is 25% of the total cost. So let's find out what is 15% of the total cost, and that will be the value of royalty. So let the amount of royalty be paid for these books be rupees R. Then 20 is to 15 will be equals to 30,600 is to R. That gives R equals to 22,950. Then let's see question number 2. What is the central angle of the sector corresponding to the expenditure incurred on royalty? Now the pie chart clearly shows that royalty equals to 15%. And we all know that the pie chart covers a total of 360 degrees. So to find the central angle corresponding to royalty, we just have to find 15% of 360 degrees. That is equal to 54 degrees. So this is the illustration of a pie chart with some examples. Now let's see a bar chart. The bar graph given below shows the sales of books in 1000 number from 6 branches of a publishing company during 2 consecutive years, 2000 and 2001. Now in this bar chart, we can see sales in 1000 numbers in one axis and B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6 as the different branches in another axis. And whereas the blue bars represent the year 2000 and the red bar represent the year 2001. So now let's see the first question. What is the ratio of the total sales of branch B2 for both years to total sales of branch B4 for both years? In this question, we have to simply add the both sale values of 2000 and 2001 for B2, that is 74 plus 65, and divide it with the sales value of the year before, that is 85 plus 94. That is equal to 140 by 180 equals to 7 by 9. Second question, what is the average sales of all branches in 1000 numbers for the year 2000? Now in this question, we have to note the different sales figure of different branches for the year 2000. That means 80, 75, 95, 85, 75 and 70. Then we have to find their mean. So we have to divide all these numbers summation with 6 and the answer is 80. So this is all about the illustration of bar charts with its examples. Now let's look at line graphs or line charts. And to understand that, let's go through the following illustration. Study the following line graph and answer the questions. This given line graph shows the export figures for three companies over the years in rupees crores, where the amount is shown in one axis, that is from 0 to 150 crores, and on the other axis, the years are shown, that is 1993, 1994, 1995, 1996, 1997, 1998, and 1999. We can also see three lines in the graph. The blue one is of company X, red one is of company Z, and green one is of company Y. So let's see the first question. For which of the following pairs of years, the total exports for the three companies together are equal? Now to solve this question, in the given graph, you have to add the amount of each company from their respective years. That means in 1993, it will be 30 plus 80 plus 60 crores, that will be rupees 170 crores. In 1994, it will be 60 plus 40 plus 90 equals to 190 crores. Similarly, for 1995, it will be 40 plus 60 plus 120 equals to 220 crores. 1996, it will be 70 plus 60 plus 90 equals to 220 crores. From 1997, it will be 240 crores. For 1998, it will be 230 crores. And 1999, it will be 360 crores. And after finding the summation for each year, now you just have to compare. And clearly, the total exports of three companies XYZ together are same during the years 1995 and 1996. Then we'll see the next question. In which year was the difference between the exports from companies X and Y the minimum? Now in this case, you have to refer the graph, take the values of export figures of companies X and Y from each year and find their difference. Like in example 1993, it will be rupees 80 minus 30, that is equal to 50 crores. 1994, it will be 60 minus 40, that is 20 crores. 1995, it will be 60 minus 40, again 20 crores. 1996, it will be 70 minus 60, that is 10 crores. 1997, it is 100 minus 80, that is 20 crores. 1998, it is 100 minus 50, that is 50 crores. 1999, it is 140 minus 120, that is equal to 20 crores. And clearly from these figures, the difference is minimum in the year 1996. So friends, this is all about data interpretation and illustration of different kind of charts with their examples.